Three dogs just wanted to go home. We clawed the rusted gates of a cage that we didn't understand. Locked in dark rooms, our only friend was the occasional flicker of a light bulb that reminded us of the sun. So we spend most nights howling at a moon that only felt safe visiting behind gated windows. They painted us like vicious animals, teeth so sharp you could feel the anger leave our open jaws as it dripped from our tongues. So the guards would come to force muzzles over our broken mouths. They told us it was medication. They looked at us like dogs that had been broken down and beaten, and we looked back at them with a stare that told ghost stories, begging and pleading to be set free. The guard wore a smile like a shotgun, and he delighted in swallowing the key. I heard that most dogs don't make it out of here alive. So we sat around in a circle and asked each other what we were in for, as if our illnesses were crimes and we were just criminals for needing help. But now we were brothers, bonded by blood, understanding each other in a way that is usually reserved for war veterans, but there were no badges made for animals. Three dogs just wanted to go home. We were strip-searched daily in a room that didn't show up on the cameras. The walls were lined with sedatives and silent screams, and you could hear the cries of misbehaving patients from down the hall. They wanted us to hear it so we would learn from example, so we never talked anymore. We'd simply sit in our beds with pillows over our heads and try to sleep. Three dogs just wanted to go home. One of which is still there, being heavily medicated to the point where his brain has just become strings to a puppet that he watches in the mirror. His parents gave up on him years ago after he started drinking and doing drugs. He was no longer the cute puppy that was worth adopting. He was just left in the kennel. Two dogs just wanted to go home. But this dog never got to. Wearing a collar fashioned out of his own hair, they found him hanging from a noose that was tied to the sun, and that light bulb never fucking flickered again. It just stayed lit to better present the shadow of a teenager that died in the arms of a monster. They made him sicker than he was when he got there. He was only 14. One dog just wanted to go home. And I did. The cathartic discharge papers felt like breathing for the first time, but I can still hear the faint howling of a pack of dogs that couldn't be domesticated. I am the lucky one. And I will never stop barking.